This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome to today's ISS update. It is Thursday, April 12th, 2012. You're looking at a live view inside the International Space Station's flight control room here at the Johnson Space Center. This is the Orbit 2 team here inside Mission Control. Today's flight director is Ed Van Sice. He is sitting there at the middle console. The Capcom today is Jeremy Hansen. The Expedition 30 crew on board the International Space Station has quite a busy day today, as they have most days working on research activity and different types of maintenance work. This is a live view. Commander of Expedition 30, Dan Burbank, on board the station. He's been removing and replacing a pump separator in the waste and hygiene compartment. This is taking up the majority of his day. He also has one last session of training as part of his role as the crew medical officer. If you saw our interview yesterday with Dr. Ed Powers, one of the flight surgeons, he talked about how various crew members are trained to basically be onboard doctors, since there's not always a medical doctor up there as part of the crew. So even though Burbank is getting close to wrapping up his time on board the station, he will go through one more proficiency training session as part of his role as one of the medical officers on board, basically just making sure that he knows how to use the various medications and medical equipment on board in case any of that should ever become necessary. He is also working with Andre Kuipers today to conduct another one of these eye ultrasounds. How the crew members' eyes react to being up in space for up to 6 months has become an area of focus here over the last few months. So they will conduct that ultrasound as they continue to measure how their eyes are behaving up there in space. Anton Shkaplerov is working in the Russian segment today on a Russian crystal experiment. He is also packing up equipment that will come home aboard the Soyuz TMA-22 spacecraft that will bring home Burbank, Shkaplerov himself, as well as Anatoly Ivanishin, coming up here in about 2 weeks. Ivanishin himself is taking some surface samples from inside the Zarya module that is part of the Russian segment. They do this periodically, basically just taking some swabs of the walls and the floorboard and the ceiling and the other surfaces, just to make sure that there's no bacteria or anything untoward growing in that area. He is also working on some crew departure preparations. Like we mentioned, he is part of the crew with Shkaplerov in Burbank that will be coming home coming up on April 27th. Oleg Kononenko is also working in the Russian segment. He is working on some stowage of the materials that came up on board the Progress 46. That particular cargo craft, which is one of the spacecrafts that service the International Space Station, came up in January. It is getting close to undocking. It's going to undock coming up on April 19th. There is the current layout of the station with the Progress 46 back there on the Pier's docking compartment. It brought up about a little bit less than 3 tons of supplies for the crew back a few months ago. There is quite a significant amount of activity that has to be done using the station's inventory management system, basically just taking the barcodes that come up with the materials that come up on the Progress, and also the ATV-3, which you see there back in the back, the automated transfer vehicle, making sure that all those cargo items get stowed in the exact spot where they need to be so that the crew may find them when the time comes to open up the packages and use whatever material came up. So he's going to be working on that today, as well as packing that Progress full of trash and other items that the crew doesn't need anymore. As we mentioned, the undocking coming up on April 19th, that will take place at 6:03 a.m. Central Time, 7:03 a.m. Eastern Time. Of course, we'll have video highlights of that coming up here on NASA TV on that day. And finally, Andre Kuipers and Don Pettit working today, as they have all week long, on training for the upcoming SpaceX mission. They started that on Monday. They started about 2 weeks' worth of training activity using the robotic workstation that is inside the Destiny laboratory. There's actually two different robotic workstations on board, one in Destiny and also down in the cupola. That's actually the one that they will be using coming up as the SpaceX Dragon heads up to the International Space Station. That launch time currently scheduled for 11:22 a.m. Central Time, 12:22 p.m. Eastern Time, coming up on April 30th. It'll take about 2 days for the Dragon to head up toward the International Space Station. So on the third day of the mission, Flight Day 3, which should be May 2nd, that Dragon will perform a flyunder of the International Space Station at about 2.5 kilometers. The crew will be monitoring that. They will be sending a quick command down to Dragon for it to turn on its strobe light. And then if all goes well during all the different checkout activities, Dragon will perform a loop of the station and set up for the next day's activities, which will be May 3rd. That'll actually be the rendezvous and berthing, if all checks out, with Don Pettit at the controls of the station's robotic arm, and Andre Korpers backing him up as those two oversee Dragon's rendezvous with the orbiting complex. We also want to remind you that coming up on Monday, the International Space Station program is going to be having its flight readiness review, where it will be taking a look at the final plans for SpaceX's mission. This final test flight is part of NASA's Commercial Orbital Transportation Services. That flight readiness review will take place here at the Johnson Space Center once it wraps up. We will have a pre-flight briefing here on NASA television to take a look at the SpaceX mission. We cannot pinpoint the exact time of that briefing, but it'll most likely be mid to late afternoon, depending on when that FRR does wrap up. But for all the latest on the exact time of the briefing, just log on to the NASA website at www.nasa.gov.